have more hot topics just around the corner, but right now, the boys from 5 Seconds of Summer, they are back down under, and our very own Angela Bishop is celebrating a very special day with them, Ange.
Well, thank you very much. Joining me this morning are the boys from 5 Seconds of Summer. Good morning, guys.
These good morning.
Are not rock star hours. What are you guys doing now?
We're feeling fresh. We've got that jet lag, so feeling good. It's about midnight where we just came from.
Surprising. There's hours before midday, which is new to us.
Yeah. Who knew?
It's quite a cool thing.
It's good. You learn something new every day.
Well, tell me why you are here. It's been a big Vegemite breakfast, National Vegemite Day. Why are you guys involved?
Just for the free Vegemite, really.
Sure.
No. We're here to support the Olympians for Rio, which starts in 50 days. We're drumming up something mighty. That's what we're doing. And, just here to rally support.
Yeah.
So what's the idea that fans help support do a bit of drumming themselves?
Basically, you can download the Vegemite app. If you could put in some graphics here, I'm scrolling down the iPhone, downloading the app, and you can video your own drum beat or shake around the electronic drum kit on the phone, and basically just support of the Olympians, which we'll be doing the relays. Yeah.
The relays,
well.
Of course.
We don't know which
I
relay.
I think we could fit as a relay team. Been, do you think?
We got the shoes for it. Today. The outfits, skinny jeans. It's surprisingly stretchy.
Right.
You know. Mm-hmm.
And the sheer speed you've got.
The sheer speed of a speed.
And what are you going to use as your baton? If you've got a drumstick, that can be your baton.
I do actually. Here we go.
There you go.
One you prepared earlier. You'll
look
see
at that.
Here. That's one.
But that can be your baton. You can pass the drumstick as a thing. So we've got you here. You're in the middle of a 101 date worldwide tour.
Is that many?
Yeah, I did a count.
Oh my God.
For a blonde isn't bad to get over 100, let me tell you. But so you've just come from Europe.
Yeah.
And then you go to the States. How's it all going?
It's been going well. Yeah, like we were saying before, we've gone to a bunch of places in Asia we've never been to before, and went to a few places in Europe we've been to before. And it's a big old American tour, and then we play some shows in Australia to finish it off.
Oh, when are you coming back? When are those?
It's
29th September.
Yeah.
That was the dates guy.
Yeah.
He's got all the dates.
Dates and times.
I studied all last night.
Do you love playing home best of all?
Yeah, we finished in Sydney. We have two shows at Horton Pavilion. We've never played there before.
No, we haven't played there.
Pretty legendary venue.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Are there any Olympians that are personal heroes of yours that you want to meet? You know.
I met Liesl Jones before.
Ah.
I used to be a swimmer, so I looked at it as well. I used to swim a lot.
Mm.
So it was amazing to meet her.
Was it a toss-up between swimming or rock stardom?
I was a bit short to be a swimmer. I am 6 foot now, but I grew very late.
Right.
So when I was 15, I was versing people who were about 7 foot, and I looked a bit ridiculous.
Hence
so
rock stardom.
So
got
I picked the sticks instead.
Picked the sticks.
Now, there's a very big movie coming out shortly called Ghostbusters. It's going to be one of the biggest movies of the year, and I hear a whisper that you guys are involved.
Yeah, we have a song on the soundtrack called Girls Talk Boys.
How awesome.
Yeah.
Is that a big deal for you guys?
Yeah, of course. Never been on a movie soundtrack, so, you know.
And did you
awesome.
Watch the first Ghostbusters as kids?
Yes.
Yes, we did.
That'd be a 10-4.
We did. We watched on the bus the other day, two of us as well. It's a classic, so the new one's going to be a reinvention of it. It's female Ghostbusters.
Hence your song.
Hence the song.
I love it when a plan comes to
life.
You guys, do you still pinch yourselves of, you know, starting out in Sydney's West and then sort of the stratospheric heights you've reached now? Do you still get a moment every now and then?
It's a nice word.
Stratospheric. Try to say it three times faster.
It's always kind of grounding to come back and see your parents, you know, still grinding along and making their own way in their lives. And it just really kind of gives you another motivation to go off.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. I mean, you speak of the Olympians before, and I think there's a huge sporting culture in Australia. And when you look up to people like I was talking about Liesl, I think it really gives you a determination to do something bigger than you think you can do. And I think that actually had a massive effect on us going, yeah, we can make it as a band. We can actually make stuff happen. So that's the cool thing about being here today.
And now you're inspiring people yourselves.
Young kids,
if they have ambitions in music, they've just got to look at you guys.
Just start a relay team.
Band/relay.
How are the fans? Are you still unable to sort of go five paces without hearing screams?
When we're back, it's cool. They're very respectful here. Seen a few of them hanging around. The last few days.
Sorry.
Have you got any special messages for them? Because they will be watching right now.
Oh,
It makes us excited when you guys get excited that we're coming home. So we're all excited.
Everyone's excited.
It's pretty epic, you know, because it's our first ever fans here in Sydney. So it's very cool.
Yeah, I can see you guys. What dates again? 29th
of September, 5th of October.
We'll be here.
Nailed it.
5 seconds of summer. Great, as always, to talk to you.
Thanks
so much for being on Studio 10.
Yeah.
Lovely.
We'll see you soon.
See you.